this very Theotokos seed to be magnified in the name of the Lord. Father, bless. Amen. O God and Lord of hosts, maker of all creation, who by the tender compassion of thy mercy, which transcludes in comprehension, descend on thine only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the salvation of our race, and by his precious cross, this tear us under the handwriting of our sins, and thereby this triumph over the principalities and powers of darkness. Be thou thyself, O Master, lover of mankind, accept also from us sinners these prayers of thanksgiving and entreaty, and deliver us from every destructive and dark transgression, from all enemies, both visible and invisible, that seek to do us evil. Nail down our flesh with fear of thee, and incline not our hearts unto words or thoughts of evil, but pierce our souls with longing for thee, that ever looking to thee and being guided by thy light, as we behold thee, the unapproachable and everlasting light, we may send up unceasing praise and thanksgiving to thee, the unmerited Father, and thy most only begotten Son, and all holy and good life-giving Spirit, now and ever, in the ages of ages. Amen.
Let us Reverend Archbishop Peter, for the Venerable Priesthood, the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this land, its authorities and armed forces, and for all who with faith and piety dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the God, preserve Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver his people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love and piety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and country, and the faithful that dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
save the pious and hearken unto us.
Take care for the eye. Saxon, or does he say it altogether for our sakes? For our sakes, no doubt, which is written, that he who plows should plow in hope, and he who threshes in hope should be partakers of his hope. If we have sown unto you spiritual things, it is a great thing if we shall reap your carnal things. If others are partakers of this power over you, are we not even more? Nevertheless, we have not used this power, but suffer all things, lest we should hinder the gospel of Christ.
Братья, сие да мудрствуется вас, еже во Христе Иисусе, иже во образе Божий Сын, не восхищением ни к чего быть и равен Богу, но себе умалил драк раба прим, подобие человеческим быть, и образом облечься, яко же человек, смирил себе, послушлив был даже до смерти, смерти же крестная. Тем же Бог ему превознесе, дарова ему имя, и же паче всякого имени. Да, по имени Иисуса всяко колено поклонится, небесных и земных и преисподних, и всяк язык исповесть, яко Господь Иисус Христос, в славу Бога.
Apart to pray, and when evening was come,
he was there alone. But their sheep was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with the waves, and the wind was contrary. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went unto them, walking on the sea. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, It is a spirit, and they cried out for fear. But straightway Jesus spake unto them, saying, Be in good cheer, it is I, but be not afraid. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water. And he said, Come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Jesus. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid and began to sink. He cried, saying, Lord, save me. And immediately Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him and said unto him, For thou little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt? And when they were come into the ship, the wind ceased. Then they that were in the ship came and worshipped him, saying, Of a truth thou art the Son of God. And when they were gone over, they came into the land of Gennesaret. Во время оно, в ней Иисус весь некую, жена же некая именем Марфа, прият его в дом свой, и сестра Ебенрица ему Мария, я же и сидевши при ногу Иисуса, вы слышаше слово Его, Марфа же, молвящая о мнозе службе, ставши же рече, Господи, не бережешь ли, яко сестра моя едиными остави служите, рцы во ей доми поможет, отвечав же Иисус рече ей, Марфо, Марфо, ты чешешься и молвище о мнозе, едино же есть на потребу, и Мария же благую часть избра, я же не отнимется от нея. Выжжег да глаголище сия, воздвигши некая жена глаз от народа рече, блаженно чрево носившая тебя, исцая же иссал, он же рече, тем же уго блаженны, слышащие слово Божие и хранящие.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Благочестие.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
И всем во Христе в родстве наше.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Вещие молимся блаженных и преснопамятных святейших патриархах православных, благочестивых царях и благоверных царицах и создателях святого храма сего, и всех прежде почивших отцов и братьев, делегащих и повсюду православных.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Стопы человеческие исправляй, Господи, призри милостиво на рабы Твоя, Евгений и Сон Анатолий Людмилу, и всех путешествующих святаго храма сего, и простив им всякое прегрешение, вольное же и невольное, благослови благое намерение совета их, и исходы их поле со путешествием исправи, прилежно молимся, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Всякие беды, всем все, Господи, услыши и скоро помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Не охватай смерти грешных, но ожидай обращения, покаяния, обрати всех отступающих ко святей Твоей Церкви, молимся, милосердный Господи, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Дабы заповедь Твою нам, ежели любите как Бога нашего и ближнего своего, сотвори до ненависти, вражды, обиды, мздоимства, клятвопреступства и прочее беззаконие прекратятся, истинная же любовь да царствует в сердцах наших. Молимся, Спаситель наш, услыши и милостивно помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Тебе, Господу Богу нашему, еже услышите глас моления нашего и молитвы, и помиловать рабов Твоих, Андрея, Самуила, Фадея, благодатью и щедротами Твоими, и исполните вся прошение их, и простите им вся согрешение вольное и невольное, благоприятным же быть и молитвам и милостям их, пред престолом владычествия Твоего, и покрыть их от враг видимых и невидимых, и от всякие напасти беды и скорби, и недугов избавите, подайте здравие с долгоденствием всем, все, Господи, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Тебе, Господу Богу нашему, и же услышите глас моления нас грешных, и помиловать рабов Твоих, митрополита Ануфрия и страждущую пасту Его, Ирея Глеба Татьяну, Анастасию, Лену, Софию, Серафима, Ирея Матвея, Архилю, Василию, Маклина, Эмилию, Софию, Ксению, и Ипатьякода Адама, Юлианию, Милицу, Чепсомарка, Виктора, Елизавету, Юлию, Михаила, и покрытие от всякие скорби, гнева и нужды, от всякие болезни душевные и телесные, и даровать же им здравие с долгоденствием, всем все, Господи, услыши, и милостивно помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Господу и Спасителю нашему, Боже, сохраните в единении правовере Церковь православную, славную во всем мире пребывающую, и даровать ей мир и безмятежную любовь и согласие, от всем все, Господи, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Призри, Владыка, человека, любчи на жертвенный подвиг больничных работников наших, воспим здравие непоколебимой силы крепость духа, мудрость к совершению трудов по благо народа нашего, и сотвори через них исцеление страждущим рабом Твоим, прилежно молимся, скоро услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Согрешихом и беззаконовахом, и сего ради праведный Твой гнев постижи нас, Господи Боже наш, и сень смертный обыди нас, и к адам вратом приближихомся. Но к Тебе, Богу нашему, в болезни нашей умиленно вопием, пощади, пощади, люди Твои, Богови до конца, смиренно молитесь, услыши, и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Животом и смертью владычествуй, Господи, из-за Твоих смерти души рабов Твоих, но пристань от гнева и остави ярость, да не исчезает века дым дни наши, и еще крепость нашей погибаем до конца грех ради наших. Милости будь рабом Твоим, покаянию со слезами молитесь и услыши, и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Исцели болезнью врачу и страсти души телес рабов Твоих, митрополита Филариона и Германа, архиепископа Кирилла Петра, епископа Георгия, архимандритов Иова Серафима, Антония, Венедикта, протоиерея Андрея, иерея Михаила, протодиакона Николая, диаконов Виктора и Льва и подиакона Сергия, рабов Божьих, Ольги, Натальи, Юлии, Любови, Льва, Татьяны, Ильяны, Анны, Николая, Веры, Ольги, Натальи, Сюсанны, Софии, Фатины, Елисаветы, Виктора, Виктории, Михаила, Ивана, Владимира, Александры, Анны, Анны, Ирины, Марии, Елены, Сергия, Стефана, Серафима, Александра, Антония, Якова, Анны, Елены, Лидии, Ольги, Дарьи, Ксении, и всех болящих святого храма сего, и прости им, якоже благосерд, вся прегрешение, вольное и невольное, и скоро воздвигнет от болезни, молимся, услыши, и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся об относящих и добродеющих по святем и сочистнем храме всем, труждающихся, боящих и предстоящих людях, ожидающих от Тебя великие и богатые милости.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи,
Господи Боже наш, я уже заповедую сие наставление. Thank you.
Кирилла, митрополита Патриарха Московского и всея Руси, и господина нашего высокопреосвященнейшего Илариона, митрополита Восточноамериканского и Нью-Йоркского, первой иерархии русской зарубежной церкви, и господина нашего преосвященнейшего Петра, архиепископа Чикагского и среднеамериканского, да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков.
Да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков. Блаженнейшего Ануфрия, митрополита Киевского и всея Украины, страждущую Пасху Его. Да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков. В надежде воскресения и жизни вечной от раб своих, новопредставленных, иеромонаха Николая и Емилии, да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков. Священство, монашество, всех немых и страждущих за веру православную, создателей и благотворителей, братьев и сестричества и поющихся того храма сего, и всех вас, православных христиан, да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и присно и во веки веков.
Focus. ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Holy Spirit, be with you all.
We are
Thou didst once forsake the world of the atonement.
we have the blessing to gather in the parish church on this last day of the Feast of the Dormition of the Mother of God. This is the last of the feasts of the year. The new year coming up on September 1st, 4th, the 14th, according to the civil calendar. So we're sort of saying goodbye to the year with this Pascha of the Mother of God. And there are very important gospel readings which we hear during this time, which I strongly recommend to you. We pass out the Good News, which has the gospel reading in it for you to read during the service. You can take that home, you can read it there. We list those things in our weekly bulletin on Sunday reading. We put it up on the website at 6 o'clock on Sundays so that you have the opportunity to follow the cadence of the church, to kind of walk along the whole week with the whole church according to the scripture readings, which are read during the service. Not everybody will be here for the service every day. We're not going to have service every day. But we can each kind of follow along and be with the cadence of the church by reading the scripture as it's appointed each day of the week. Today we hear a really famous gospel. They're all kind of famous, actually, if you think about it. But we don't really think about it. We hear about the Lord walking on the water. The disciples, he sends out in a boat in Lake Gennesaret, Sea of Tiberias, if you want to call it that, or Lake Galilee, if you want to call it that. It's all the same body of water, by the way, in case you weren't sure, in northern Israel, in a massive pit, which is very warm. I mean, we may even say hot. I remember we were there with Archbishop Peter once, it was over 100 degrees there, and that was in September, I don't recall exactly. But anyway, it's very hot there. And sometimes there are very big storms. And this is what happened to the apostles in today's gospel. They're out in the ship in a huge storm. The Lord had sent them ahead of himself. And what was he doing? He was off praying. Why does God have to pray? Right? We've talked about this before, but I think it's worth revisiting. God does not have to pray. Nor does God have to be baptized. Nor does God have to do a lot of things. In fact, God doesn't have to do anything because he's in charge. He can do as he likes. But he gives us the example of being baptized, of prayer, and of other things, so that we will emulate him. So when we see something like this in the gospel, immediately we should be attentive to that and say, that's for me. Because everything that's written in the gospel, brothers and sisters, was for those who were around the Lord at the time, and for every person who lives and hears that gospel until the Lord comes again. So those words are also for us. And in fact, this time, when there was no one around him anyway, it's all for us. Give us the inspiration. When we feel a little bit lazy, oh, I don't want to pray, you know, my wife made me, cut the grass again today, and it's hot, and so on and so forth, and there wasn't enough beer, and so I don't really want to pray. Well, but the Lord went off, even after a long day preaching to the people and teaching them, he went off and prayed. He had always this interaction with the Father and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Trinity is only the Holy Trinity. But for us, he went to pray. Now, that's only the first part of the gospel. The second part, I think, is very important for us and something we have to be really attentive to. And that's when the Lord is walking on the waves to the apostles. They're in the ship. The storm is bad. It looks pretty bad for them. They may not make it to the other side of the lake, which is actually not that far, but far enough that you can understand how they might be concerned about that. And here comes the Lord walking to them on the water. Which, on one hand, is a great miracle, but we've kind of become cold to such things. We're like, well, that's God. They walked on the water. Okay, but Peter walked on the water. And Peter's not God. Now that should get our attention. This does not mean that we are all being called to go find the nearest body of water and give that a try today. It's kind of warm, maybe it's not bad, but you're unlikely to have much success. Peter's walking on the water also was for us. Because he was doing great when he was all there with Christ. Once they realized that was Christ on the water, they were a little scared before that. Then they were all about that. And then Peter, being bold, said, hey, I want to come to you. And the Lord said, do it. And so he begins to walk, and he's okay. But then the waves are kind of big. And he gets worried. He begins to doubt.
obviously this is a metaphor. I mean, it really happened, but it's also a metaphor for us in our spiritual lives. How often do we ask God's help, but then we waver? Or we don't even get to the point of asking God's help. We just go right to the waiver, because that's just faster and easier for us. We go right to the doubt, we go right to the difficulty, we go right to the everything is bad, I can only see bad here, sunshine 99% of the time, I'm going to think about 1% chance of rain. Sometimes that's just the way we are, but we've got to break that. As Orthodox Christians, we can't live that way. That's not us. We're thankful people. We're people that see whatever God sends as good, or at least we struggle to do that. Because everything that God sends, everything, is for our salvation. And therefore, it's all good. But as it comes in, we sort of say, that's bad, that's good, bad, bad, bad. And mostly this is, I have to work, work, work. Good, I can do nothing here. So this is how we delineate what the Lord sends to us. But when He sends it, it's only for our salvation. And so, brothers and sisters, let's understand that Peter doubted, and he should not be condemned for being a human, because we all doubt. That's part of our human nature. There are other places in the gospel where it says that too. We like the gospel as a concept, but we don't read it very carefully. And especially when it says, and go forth and do this, we start to think, well, that must be for somebody else. No, that's for us. And at the end of Matthew, we hear how even after the Lord was resurrected and he met them in Galilee, some still doubted, even though he's standing right in front of them. What does it mean? It means that that's part of our lives. That's just a struggle that we all have. Even the very apostles who stood in the presence of Christ. And that's okay. What we sometimes do, though, is say, oh, doubt. That must mean I've completely rejected belief. Why? Everyone else in the world doubts. Why you should be so special that you get to say that's the end? It's not. That's just part of the struggle. And that's what we see in Peter today. It's not that he was like, oh, I decided you're not the Son of God, and he was done. It's not that at all. He just began to doubt. He began to give in to his human weakness. And that's something that we all struggle with, brothers and sisters. So, next time, when we're in that position, metaphorically, not on the water, when we're beginning to doubt and struggle, let's remember that Peter only had trouble when he began to embrace that doubt. When he was looking at Christ, and he understood that God is before me, and we have to understand that God is always also with us. Sometimes we sort of say, go stand in the corner because I don't need you now. But that's wrong. We always need God to be with us, just like Peter needed him there on the water. So brothers and sisters, let us not give in to despair. Let us not give it any place in our lives. Whether we are interpreting what the Lord sends us as good or bad, let us remember that it's all for our salvation. And therefore, on some level, even though it's very difficult for us sometimes, it's all good. And if we can remember Peter and the fact that he could walk on that water with God, with that strong faith in God, and only when he began to doubt did he fall, then when we begin to doubt, let us redouble our efforts to look towards the Lord, to turn towards Him and ask His help. And if we can do that, brothers and sisters, then today's gospel is for us not just some sort of interesting spectator sport where there's a couple of guys walking on the water. This gospel is for us, for our salvation. May the Lord grant this to all of us. Amen.
Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save. save sinners, that's my inference. I believe also that this is truly thine own most dear body, and that this is truly thine own precious blood. Therefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of the word and of deed, committed in knowledge or in ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most dear mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communion, for I will not speak of thy mysteries or enemies. Neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like thee will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the meaning of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment, nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body. Amen. Veniu Gospodis, Veniu Iacotis, Simonis, Tu, Christos, Simbogo, Givago, Prisceli, Mirtecni,
надо исповедовать за перед причастием. Если вы не исповедовались, а вы хотите причащаться, идите ко мне после службы, мы найдем хорошее время для вас исповедоваться и после этого причащаться. Brothers and sisters, in order to partake of Holy Communion, you must be an Orthodox Christian who's been to confession. If you've not been to confession, but you desire to partake of Holy Communion, come to me or Father Colin after the service. We will find a good time for you to go to confession, and after that, to partake of Holy Communion.
thy praise, O Lord, that we may sing of thy glory. For thou hast made us worthy to partake of thy holy, divine, immortal, and life-creating mysteries. Keep us in thy holiness, that all the day we may meditate upon thy righteousness.
Apostles,
Our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, the Holy Martyr Lupus, the Holy Higher Martyr Irenaeus of Lyon, the Holy Equal to the Apostles, Great Prince Vladimir, the Holy Righteous Ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good, and the lover of mankind.
Amen. I pray God and Father, his holiness, Kirill, Patriarch of Moscow and of Russia, our Lord and Mary, my servant, Hilario, Metropolitan of Eastern America, the Lord for Sarah, for the Russian Church abroad, our Lord and Most Reverend Peter, Archbishop of Chicago and in America, and their God protected for this land and civil authorities and our forces, the God preserved Russian land, the right of this holy British Orthodox Christians, reserve all the for many years. O Lord, love our foundation of those that put their trust in thee. Do thou confirm the church which thou hast purchased with thy precious blood.
After we kiss the cross, we invite everyone to stay with us for our meal. We ask a donation of $7 for adults, $4 for students, guests, and children eat free. So please stay with us, brothers and sisters. During our meal, we will have our second quarter stewardship education question and answer period, and also give you the opportunity, if you need some help, setting up a recurring donation, we'll have folks that can help you do that. Remember our mask recommendation, which is not a mandate. We have to be patient and empathetic with each other and very understanding if someone's making a choice other than us at this point. God willing, things will not get worse, but at least for now, we're recommending but not mandating that people wear masks. Parish church school registration is open online. I thought maybe Sasha would be here today, but I think she just came back from Ukraine, so she's a little jet lagged. You won't be able to see her today. We're starting on October 2nd. A few years ago, we decided we were not going to try to start before the festival. It's just not practical. So you can sign up. It's in the email. It's on the website. You can try to avoid it, but it's there. So please sign up as early as possible, your children, for church school. Speaking of school, our parish school, the Ann Arbor Orthodox Classical Academy, things are moving forward. We are going to have Jack will tell you a little bit of what's going to happen this week. But I can tell you that we've put an offer, to a teacher who will lead our online offerings for this year. So I'm very excited to say that we are going to have classes this year. They're going to be online because we can't have them in the building yet, but thank God for that. Also, every Wednesday this year, except for the few that are during the break times, we will have liturgy here and then a Law of God lesson for pre-K students. So please make a note of that. If we get enough volunteers for that, then we'll also have a mother's group. If not, mothers will be here to children. So if you think that you might be able to help on Wednesday mornings during that Law of God for pre-kindergartners, that would be really helpful. Then, like I said, the moms can have some time together to speak and to sort of help each other. Fasting this week is a little different. Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. Saturday because there are two one-day fasts in the church. No, three. Two of them are in September. The beheading of St. John the Baptist, which is this Saturday, and the exaltation of the cross. We won't ask what the other one is. We know that you all understand it's that day before the altar, so that you will win Orthodox Jeopardy next time. All right, so please be attentive to that, and note that the services on Friday night and Saturday morning, that will be our call in this cycle for the week. The services for the week are up on the glass doors. They're also in the Sunday reading. They're also on the website. We have several services this week, including we have begun on Thursday evenings, 6 o'clock Vespers, followed by adult catechism. So if you're interested in that, talk to Father Colin. He'll tell you more about that. There's several things that we're interested in, and thank God for that. So the services this week, Tuesday night at 6 o'clock, Wednesday morning, 8 o'clock, liturgy. Thursday night, 6 o'clock, Vespers and adult catechism, then Friday night, 6 o'clock, that'll be a vigil, and Saturday morning, divine liturgy, 8 o'clock, all in English. Now, festival. It's all festival all the time now. So over here we have posters, which are being covered up, and I'm sure it will be uncovered shortly by the bread that we're going to be giving out. There are also signs everywhere. There's signs, and they're in the back. You can take yours. How do you know it's yours? Because you live near that place. There are maps there, and it shows the neighborhood where the map, where the signs go, and it shows even exactly where they're supposed to go. Right? We don't have a GPS chip on them. We're not going to check you, but please take those and find someone to do it with, because it can be a little dangerous if you're running out of the car by yourself and driving and you forget, don't go on the brake, the car drives away, whatever. So take your signs and put them on, please, this week. It's very important. This is what people are looking for. That many people, actually I can tell you about 30,000 people a week see that billboard, but people need to see it also in their neighborhood. So please take the signs and put them out this week. Thank you very much for that. I think that's everything I've got. So festival news, and we will be doing the sign up for the festival during the meal. So I'll bring it around. Marina's not here, so the nice festival leader is not here. So you've got me and Father Gregory. So I'll come with the pen and the sign up poster, and I'm sure that we can reach a mutually agreeable level of your volunteerism for the festival. But we know that everybody wants to volunteer to be part of the thing. I see Carl in the back raising his hand.
Yeah, it's really important that if you actually do change your location of a sign slightly, right, change your map and keep your map so that the day after the festival, you go get your signs. Because we don't want signs hanging around. We don't need Scioto Township. We don't need Lima Township. We don't need the City of Ann Arbor getting on our case because we're not taking our signs down.
Right, I mean, we put Carl's cell phone on the back of those signs and said that the problem is I understand what he's saying. We do not want the cities to not like us, the municipal people. We want them to like us. When we show up there with our hands out for something, we want them to say, oh, you're the people that picked your signs the day after. We like you. Yes, Tom?
I would add, they're roughly $8 a sign, and we keep them, and when the dates show up again, we reuse them so we don't have to pay another however many hundreds of dollars to have signs printed. So we store them in the barn when they're not in use, and then we have a whole range of dates, and whatever date is used, we can just reuse them, and it's just the money back to us that we don't have to spend again.
That's a good point. Thank you for making that. That's a real valid point. It's not there just a box. That's real money. Other announcements? Johnson.
Festival announcement. As Father Gregory said, he'll be coming around with a send-up sheet on to help on the days of the festival. However, festival of the magnitude that we have requires lots of preparation. Many people are already participating. Thank you so much for doing that. If you have not had a chance to have dinner with the men or bake or chop with the women, but you'd like to help and you can't hold a knife or something, but you can help me this week to go shopping. I need to go to Restaurant Depot to purchase all of those supplies that we use during the festival, plates and forks and all that stuff, good stuff. There are humongous boxes, there's lots of them. I've done it before by myself. You know, I need help of a young man. All men that I see here are all young, so any one of you will work. If you have time this week, I can be flexible, so please come talk to me and say, I have about 3 hours that I can spare, and I will be exhilarated. If there's two of you at different times, I have two shopping trips. Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Any other announcements?
Yeah. I want to tell all of you, and please remind any of the other brothers or sisters that are going to use the barn, it is now alarmed. If you go in without having me or Father Gregory disarm it for you, the police are going to come. And I'm going to tell them to take you away. I'm tired of all the alarms for that. But seriously, we don't want you to have a bunch of false alarms to the point of where they are going to disregard our alarms.
Peter and the Wolf.
Or start charging.
Peter and the Wolf.
Yeah, so we have to be careful about that. So please, go to the barn. It's off limits unless you call, and we will disarm it for you. We don't have to be here. We can do it on our phone. We can disarm it. I will get with Father Gregory, and we'll get some codes made for certain groups, and we'll have them off as needed basis. But that's it. I want to also thank you all for all your help with that. And please, we have some new members here. Please be sure to welcome them and say thank you for coming. We appreciate everybody that joins us. And that's it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Jack. Any other announcements?
Yes, John. If you didn't have enough festival news, I'll get some more for you. We are 2 weeks out from the festival. I have essentially one work party next Tuesday, and I have quite a bit of work. There's lights to be installed in the barn and a whole host of other jobs. I'll be here around 6:30 on Tuesday evening. Anyone who can join me would be very, very helpful. By next Tuesday, the tents may already be here. I have to call the tent company and find that they either deliver them Tuesday or Wednesday morning. I'm not quite sure which time this year. So essentially, next Tuesday is my last official pre-festival work party. So there's quite a bit of work to do. Lots of little things, and so they tend to be time-consuming, kind of 80-20 rule. That 20% of the work takes 80% of the time. It is what it is, so I could really use some help.
Is that the 7th? Down to the 14th. The 7th or the 14th?
Both.
Is there a work
party
this Tuesday?
Both.
The coming up Tuesday. Okay. Next week.
There's one for the next 2 weeks.
And then the other one, there may be a work party. I have to see if the tents are here, we're already doing stuff. And I won't have a work party because
Don's talking about 2 days from today. When he says next Tuesday, he means 2 days from today.
Yeah,
if you talk to him later about how he understands what next is, we're not going to try to unpack that. But anyway, it'll be this Tuesday.
The only thing I was going to say, I'm sorry I forgot to talk about the church school, but they've all had a long enough time, so you can come up and see me and I'll tell you any of the news that you'd like to know about.
Lots of good stuff happening. There's going to be a lot more construction in these next few weeks. All right, let's sing Many Years Now for those who have celebrated their names. We had several names they celebrated this week, so let's do that. And we also want to congratulate Patrick, who was came to the church today and was made a catechist. He's been with us for some months, and we're very happy that now he's taking that next step and pointing towards the
Christ. Подашь, Господи, рабом Твоим, Андрею Самуилу Фадею, и сохрани на многое лето.
Marketing ministry, for our souls and bodies, and everything possible.
Бог наш, молитвами пречистая своей матери, и же Господи Отца нашего Иоанна, архиепископа Константина, града Златоустого и всех святых, помилуйте спасет нашего благи человеку. Еще раз поздравляю всех причастников. Congratulations again to everyone.